Word of the angel of the Lord. David became frightened. And I want you to know that these angels that God is sending and these things that God is allowing to happen now, fear not, O Shabbat, for the Lord is what? The Lord is with thee. I say again, fear not, for the Lord is with thee. The Lord is with thee. First Chronicles chapter 21. Watch this. First Chronicles chapter 21. And Adonai gave an order to the angel, and he put his sword back in his sheath. And when David saw that Adonai had answered him at the threshing floor of Armon, the Euphus, he sacrificed there for at that time, the tabernacle of Adonai, which Moses had made in the desert, together with what? The altar for burnt offerings, wherein the high place of given. You know, so we see here that God is allowing the angels of the Lord, even in the holy, holy places of God. What? You know, you're not, you don't have to be fearful of it, but they're out. And it is all about following Yehovah's instructions. That's why the Lord commanded the angel, and he returned his sword back into self, you know. But David could not go forth before what? It to inquire of God. For he was what? He was afraid of what? The sword of the angels of the Lord. The angels of the Lord are serious. These aren't things that you just take from slack. And you know, you get people that just got this emotional stuff. All they want to do is they want to come at you with their religious spirit. As I said in the beginning of this, they hear something, you know, I mean, like, I used to hear them say different things to me. They say this, that, and the other. Listen, I used to ask questions. And I would ask so many questions because, you know, I had a mind. So just because you say something to me and you think that you got some kind of power over you, and, you know, you turn to red and blue and purple and slopping at the mouth, don't mean I'm going to listen to you. I'm going to ask you what you mean by that. Because, you know, most of the people that you deal with, especially on the West, you know, you deal with people that speak the Queen's language. And you can use those words 13 different ways. And they can have 13 different meanings. You had a high service. You had a good service. You had no service. Whatever. I don't know what all that means. God's going to do this. God's going to do. They're quick to say God is going to do this and that. And then the funny part about it is they'll give you point to point how they do something. They always put their self in front of Yehovah. So now guess what? So, all right. So say somebody has you to prayer, somebody or you're moved to lay hands on somebody. Why would you put yourself in that? Soon as you put yourself over the work, over the experience, it makes it smaller. Everybody knows you're small. Ain't nothing big about you. So we need to learn how to allow that to know that those are the angels of God that are working for us. And Yehovah is the experience that we're going to have based on the army of the angels that the angels of the Lord has released. The Lord has released the angels as your army. Amen. And so there are things in spiritual realms that are working for us. The seraphims, the cherubs, and the archangel. And I need to correct that from the beginning. So the seraphims say, you're holy, you're holy. And then you got the cherubs. I said that wrong. Yeah. The cherubs, then the seraphims, then the archangels. And so there's deity and there's different levels even with the angels. Even as it's in worship, you know. The seraphims say to each other, he's holy, he's holy. The cherubs look to Yehovah and say, you're holy, you're holy. And you have the two archangels, because the one archangel was moved out. And then you have Yeshua, because Lucifer was an archangel and he was a cherub. He had two positions, but the only thing they had, the only person that had a greater position would have been Yeshua, because Yeshua was the son of Jehovah. Amen. And so that's understanding the ranking and the order of the angels. And so when you put that in perspective, you can understand the army. You can understand the army. So there's order in everything, you know, and there's order in everything except for some people that overnight got a scripture and a verse, and everything about them is this 100%. You know, they brag about everything. They brag about how much they give. They grab about this, that, and the other. Just trivial stuff. I mean, you know, you don't have to be on Wall Street or be a billionaire to let them know that they really ain't doing nothing. You know, you got 1 or 2% of people that are really wealthy in this country. Pretty much the world. You know, the majority of people are dealing with poverty and dealing with issues. You know, people get a car, get a house, and you got to listen to it for 20 or 30 days. Sometimes years. You know, and you know, it's just, this is not the time for that, because what Jehovah is saying, son, let the people know that I am releasing an army that will war for them, that will war for them, that will fight for them, you know, that will fight for them. And it came to pass on a certain night that the angel Lord went out, what, and killed in the camp of Assyrians 185,000. And when the people arose early in the morning, what did they do? They were coarse, all dead. Let's go to that scripture. I think that's in 2 Kings. Now, listen to this. So now you sitting up here worrying about, you know, you worrying about what your ex-husband is going to do to you. You worrying about what your lawyer is going to do to you. You worrying about what this person, you know, their intimidation tactics, what they're going to do to you. Listen to what this one angel. Now, imagine, I seen angels as far as I can see. Listen to what this says. That night in 2 Kings 19 and 35, that night the angel of Adonai went out and struck down 185,000 men in the camp of Asherah. And early the next morning, they were all of them were corpse dead. Amen. You know, we're here, we got to send ships and we got to send planes and all that stuff. But it took one angel, Oshabai. I hope you can get that in your spirit. One angel, speak to one angel, and it can kill 185,000 men, Oshabai, in one night. Oh, bless his name. The angels of God in the Hikaboshaya, Mandari Osaya, understanding the power of the angels of God. We have to learn how to operate and function with the angels of God and use them to our ability, huh? You know, because then immediately when an angel of the Lord struck him, and because he did not give glory to God, and he was eaten by worms and he died. And let me get that scripture. That's the king. Listen, let me tell you something. That's why, just like I just said earlier, it's important that you stop taking glory for everything, making yourself some kind of wonder. And if you're smart, you don't let no, listen, let me tell you something. You don't let no pastor, somebody calls themselves a pastor that you feel as though that you're indebted to the rest of your life. Good luck with that one. But I'm going to tell you right now, you don't let nobody, apostle, bishop, pastor, teacher, look, you don't let nobody put you up in nothing. You don't let nobody put you up in a position. God will confirm that stuff through his word. Because people will put you up, but guess what? I tell you what, you go all the way up, it's quicker than the fall, is a whole lot quicker than what it takes you to get up there. So you better pay attention. You don't take accolades and take credit for nothing. Listen to this. Because people pat you on the back, especially if you give them money. You stop giving money, you stop having money, most of the people won't be bothered with you. But if you giving them some money and this and that, listen, man, they smile to keep that money. And without your money, they couldn't do none of the stuff that they doing. Ain't no angels around them. Acts 12, 23 and 24. Verse 23 says, at once, Because Herod did not give the glory to Jehovah, an angel of Adonai struck him down, and he was eaten away by worms and died. But the word of the Lord went on growing and being multiplied. Listen, you can be self-righteous and all that stuff. You can take all the accolades, all you want, all you want. You can do all that. And let me tell you something. The Bible here teaches us what Herod, what happened with Herod. You know, the Bible says that the angel of the Lord, what, struck him down because he would not give God glory. And the angel struck him down and he was eaten by worms and died. But that didn't stop. That didn't stop because he wouldn't give God glory. Let me tell you something. You're going to end up, some people going to end up in their little box. And they think that's going to stop God. That ain't stopping nothing. That ain't stopping nothing. The work of the Lord still shall go on. Amen. Long after you're gone, you better believe the work of God is still going to go on. And you need to know that God is not playing in this season, in this space. God is not playing. I'm going to close with this. Do not forget to entertain what strangers, for by doing so have unwillfully entertained angels. You never know who you're looking down on or who you're talking about. You don't know the angels that God has placed in front of you. You know, oftentimes you talk down to them and you look at them and you want to make fun of them and you know this, that, and the other. But that you don't know, that can be an angel. That could be one of God's angels. It could be sister Lucy, brother Ted, brother Frank, whoever. And the angels of God could be coming and jumping them, and or even be beside them and instruct them. You know where you could give them a coin. And you bless the angel of God. It could be somebody crossing the street. It could be somebody opening up the door for you. Whatever it is, you don't want to overlook nobody and nothing. Oh, Shabbat. You must have the characteristics of Jehovah. You must move with the characteristics of Jehovah. That must be your position, the characteristics of Jehovah. And it is so. But do not, in Hebrews 13 and 2, but do not forget be friendly what to outsiders, for in so doing some people without knowing it have entertained angels. Just because they don't look like you, just because they don't smell like you, don't mean that God ain't with them. And you have to be careful and know what you're doing in this place and in this season. This is the space of God, and this is the time for the things of God. This is the time. This is the time. So I'm going to pray with you tonight. I want you to know that Jehovah has released. He said, I release my angels to be your army. He's released. And so God is speaking to somebody. He's put his word on your mouth. All you need to do is begin to speak the word of God in the space, in the season. And you're going to see things happen like you've never seen them before. God is going to do some great things in you and for your life. This is the time of Jehovah for you. This is the time of Jehovah, and God is doing it. I'm telling you, if you would just draw your spirits in and just know that he's Alpha and Omega, our beginning and end, and he has released angels of God to fight for you. Yes, he has. 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 There are angels of Jehovah that are warring for you tonight. They're warring for you tonight. They're warring for you tonight. They're warring for you tonight. The angels of Jehovah are warring for you tonight. The angels of the Lord are warm for you tonight. And Father, I thank you for your word. I give you glory and I give you honor, Lord. I pray, Lord God, that this great outpouring, Lord, every listener, Lord, would experience the angels of Jehovah, even as they listen to this, Lord. The angels, the warring angels of Jehovah, be their experience tonight, tomorrow afternoon or morning, Lord, whenever they shall listen. With the flappings of the wing, the angels overcrowd to take over their space. Take over the space farther than they could see, Lord. The presence of the angels be evident. Let that be their experience, Lord. And I thank you, Lord. And I give thy name glory and I give thy name praise, Lord. Heal, set free, and deliver, Lord. Meet every need of your people. Meet every need of your people.